Yesterday we have discussed regarding to sum of subsets, how many kinds of sum of subsets will be there for a given problem we have discussed. Today I'd like to concentrate on graph coloring. So what is the importance of graph coloring here? Let me explain by taking one small example here. Small example will be taken into consideration for explaining the graph coloring here. Let us consider this is the graph. So this could be the graph here, and these are the different vertices which are available within the graph, and edges also be there here. Now I'd like to consider the degree of graph is, look at this, the degree of 2 will be equal to 4. Okay, that is the highest degree. Of course, degree of 4 also will be equal to number of edges which are incident on one particular vertex will be called as a degree. So here it is undirected graph. So just a general graph. So here highest degree for this particular graph is degree of 2, and degree of 4 will be equal to 4. So degree of particular highest degree of a particular vertex will be so considered as a D, for example D, then you must have plus one number of colors are required to color this particular graph here. Okay, to color this particular graph. And this is the map which we have taken into consideration of that particular color. Look at this, one is being connected with so look at this, one has been connected with 2 and connected with 3 and connected with 4. So you could observe here, one has been connected with 2, one has been connected with 3 and 4, and then followed by 2 has connected with 2 will be connected with 1. Yes, 2 has connected with 1 and 3. So here in this way it has been connected, and with 4 and with 5 2 has connected. Okay, like this the pattern or the map has been drawn. For this particular map, how could you color this one? So that is the basic idea behind this particular coloring is, so if you are supposed to color this particular graph on vertices, these are the vertices which are having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are vertices which are having with us. So no two vertices are having same color if they are adjacent to each other. No two vertices are having same color if they are adjacent to each other. Adjacent in the sense, they might be having some direct edge between. So a vertex which we have to color, and with the same color, another vertex will be taken into same color. So that must not be connected to the vertex here. For example, I'd like to take red color and fill it. And you are not supposed to fill the same color with the 2, 3 and 4, because these are all these 2, 3 and 4 are adjacent to 1. So you are not supposed to fill with that particular color. So that you have to take another color and fill with another color by 2, because red has been taken for 1 and blue has been taken for 2. Okay, now let me take another color. So let me take, wait for a while. Let me take another color, green. Let me fill here. So therefore, all these three colors are different colors, and one is adjacent to 3 and 2 is adjacent to 3. So therefore, no two different types of vertices are having same kind of color here. Let me take another color and fill with 4. Let me take, probably that might be same. Okay, take another color, so fill with this particular color. Look at this, the purple color has been taken. Now, so consider one is connected, one is adjacent to all 2, 3, 4, and 2 is adjacent to, so 1, 2, 3 and 4, everything is adjacent to 2, and 3 is adjacent to 3, 4 and 1, sorry. 3 is adjacent to 1, 2 and 4, and 5 is not adjacent to 1 here, so that I'd like to fill 5 with the same color which I have filled with filled with one here. So it is not adjacent to this one here. So now graph coloring gets filled here. Now look at this. This is one, and then two has been filled with this color. Three has been filled with the green, and the four has been filled with the purple. Five has filled with again the red here. How many colors we have used? Four colors. Okay, plus one color also be used. So provided if you want to make that particular entire graph into more colorful. So four colors are enough. So since it is not fully connected graph, if it is a fully connected graph, obviously you must require maximum degree plus one number of colors are required here. Maximum number of degree plus one number of colors are required if it is. So this is the basic idea. This is the basic idea regarding to graph coloring in backtracking method. Now, so you have given a particular graph, a G will be given. A graph might be having several number of vertices, so V comma several number of edges. And this particular graph is undirected graph, and also given a number that is M. M is a particular number which will be considered as number of colors to be colored this particular graph. Okay, and for this particular graph, this number is called as a chromatic number. This number is called as a chromatic number, and based on the chromatic number, less than or equal to number of colors can be used to color the graph. Okay, so that is the basic idea. So let us go ahead and discuss the thing in a theoretical way. So look at this. G be the graph, and M be the positive integer which will be given to you. And we have to identify what is the actual point, what is the actual algorithm here is. So G can be colored in such a way that no two adjacent nodes, so N over DES, not N over TS, nodes have the same color, and you are expected to use only M number of colors only, where M will be, so M must be equal to, so maximum degree plus one. That is the M value. Okay. Then this problem is also called as M colorability decision problem. And the degree of a given graph will be, for example, it could be D, what I am just specified to you. So the degree of color of the graph will be D. Then you are expected to use D plus one colors. That is M equal to maximum of D plus one. Number of colors will be taken into consideration. Whatever the colors it might be. In the problem, we would like to consider colors will be 1, 2, 3, 4. So afterwards, while filling the same in real time, so you have to consider that M, one will be some color, two will be another color, three will be another color, something like that. Okay. Then one of the inputs, M. So one of the inputs of M, so that is M is also called as a chromatic number, as I just told you just a couple of moments ago. It is a chromatic number. So we need to identify the how many number of colors will be given by the problem, whether you may be used to complete number of colors or less than complete number of colors. So will be the actual problem which is being identified. Okay. So this is the thing. For doing this particular operation, so let us take one small example and then perform the same thing as like as this particular thing. Let us perform the same thing by using graph coloring with backtracking method. How that could be done? Let us have a look here. For example, you may be given, this is the graph you may be given. Where it is? Oh, sorry. Yeah, so you may be given 1 followed by 2 followed by 3 and then followed by this is 0. Okay. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. And the edges of this particular graph will be seen in such a way, so like this. This is the graph, and you are given the value of m will be equal to 3. Okay, value of m is equal to 3. Actually, so we must take highest degree of this particular graph will be 3. Actually, we must take 4. But the problem has restricted to give as 3 here. Number of colors which you have to use is 3. So therefore, you have to start your work and you have to identify whether so-called colors are supposed to be work properly or not. So here backtracking can be always used. And this backtracking will be basic idea regarding to backtracking is you must be always generate state space tree to identify the solutions of backtracking method, so that we just draw the backtracking method state space tree for identifying the solution by using the backtracking method. Okay, let us consider we would like to take a first and foremost item. So let us consider we'd like to start at this particular area, and it may be get started. Always it does have some kind of root. For example, one in the sense, let me consider R red. So two in the sense that is green, and then three in the sense B blue, RGB. So these are the three different types of colors which are used to generate all other colors, so that people will be always interested to take only these colors. Let me write RGB here, otherwise 1, 2, 3. Either thing is okay here. So let us consider there are three different types of colors, so that this particular root might be having three possibilities. Possibility number 1, possibility number 2, possibility number 3. Possibility number 1, so let me write on the left hand side, X will be equal to, otherwise X1, first vertex color will be equal to number 1, that is red. You can consider. Otherwise, number 2, that is green. Otherwise, number 3, that is blue. Okay. So, either of these possibilities will be there. So, let us take this one. So here, I'd like to consider first color will be colored on this particular thing. That is, color number 1 has been taken. If you have any confusion, let me write red only. So, here it is. Green only. Here it is blue only. Okay, so this is red. Let me write red as it is. Yes, I have been taken red here. Then, so is it possible to take one more color here in the second? This is first. Okay, vertex number 0 here. Sorry, vertex number 0. This is vertex number 1. Okay, so here there are X2. Second vertex might be taking. So there is a possibility of red. There is another possibility of green. There is another possibility of blue here. There are three different types of possibilities. So if you take red, so already vertex 0 is adjacent to vertex 1, so that the bound function will not be accepted. What is the bound function here? So no two vertices have same color. No two vertices have same color. So you are not supposed to take same color for the two adjacent vertices. So it is not supposed to be taken into consideration, so that you have to backtrack. Go to here and try for this particular color, that is G, that is green. Yes, it is eligible. Green is eligible because so far we haven't used green in this particular problem. Now vertex number 2, let us take into consideration vertex number 2. So this vertex number 2 do also have, let me draw in a particular way. Yeah, yes, do also have, so there is a possibility X3 will be equal to, so red, and there is a possibility green. There is another possibility, so blue, that is B. So if you take red here, if you take go ahead with the red, yes, adjacency vertex of 2 is either 3 or it is 1. Either 3 or it is 1. 3 is not yet colored, and 1 is colored with G, green. So there is no problem. So that we would like to go ahead with so red only. Then we'll move back to 3 here. So here we have colored as red. We have colored as red here. Because 2 is not adjacent to 0, so therefore there is no problem. It could be colored with red as usual. Then here also 3 possibilities again. Possibility number 1, so that is X4. So that is X4 will be equal to, so red or green or so blue here. Or blue, there is one more possibility. So if you want to take red here, red is not possible because already so 3 is adjacent to, 3 is adjacent to both 0 and 1. So it is not possible to take red here. So go for backtracking and try for green. So 3 is adjacent to, so 1 is already taking green. So that here also it is not possible. These two will be killed by backtracking, and go backtrack and checking for blue. Yes, blue will be possible. So this is the solution. So here you can apply for blue. So therefore you can see what are the colors you are supposed to specify here. So X1. So let me write in proper way. So X1, comma, so X2, comma, X3, comma, X4. So take these values, will be taken. So first one is red, X1. So first vertex will be taken red. Second vertex will be taken green. Third vertex will be taken again red. And the fourth vertex will be taken the blue. If you want to write in terms of numbers, so first vertex will be taken first color, second vertex will be second color, third vertex will be first color again, fourth vertex will be third color. So this is the decision. This is the decision which we have to come across. In this way, you have to finish up your problem. And are there any other possibilities? Yes, you can try for other possibilities also. You do have many number of possibilities. So if you are I don't want to make this particular first color as red. I'd like to start with green. Yes, it could be. So if we start with green in the sense it is green, so then probably this is red and this is green and this is blue as well. This is blue as well. Okay, G R G B. So that is one more possibility. Otherwise, if you start with, let me take another color. If you start with, blue here, blue and red as well, red will be taken. Here also blue and here it is green. So there are many solutions actually. There are many solutions. But you are expected to solve single solution, something like this. So finally, state space tree will be seen in such a way. State space tree will be seen in such a way. Okay. So, one moment, please. I'm connecting my cell phone to system. Yes, we can take this one here. Let us take something here. Let me draw here in a particular way, then it would be very easy to understand. So look at this. So you have to start the work with first one. So that is 0. Then followed by it will be taken. So red or green or blue. three different types of possibilities. And then if you take, this is the value of zero, and if you this is the first vertex zero, and let me take another vertex, another side, that will be first vertex number one. So there are three possibilities. One is red will be taken in the consideration, then this will be killed by backtracking, and you go ahead with the green. Yes, you will take a green here. Now coming to second vertex here, second vertex, and here you maybe have red. Okay, if you take red, yes, it could be possible. Then so here you could take one more. Red is killed, and then green is killed. Red is killed, and green is killed, and then it could be possible to take blue. Okay, here the solution is gets out. In this way, you can draw, and so x1, x2, x3, and x4. These values will be equal to 1, 2, 1, 3. In this way, you have to draw. Probably previously, I have written everything on the paintbrush. Probably you people could not get the property here. I'm writing using my pen, so it could be more better. Okay. So this is the solution where exactly you have to take into consideration. And you please try with the green as the primary color, otherwise first color. Then also try for blue as the first color. Okay, blue as first color. If you want to take green as first color, then obviously you could get something like this. Green will be taken. So x1, x2, x3, x4 values will become something like this. Something like this. So first one is green in the sense 2. So 2, 1, then 2 followed by 3. This is the answer. And the same thing in terms of blue in the sense 3. So if you take a 3, so 3, probably you can consider 2 and a 3 followed by 1. This is one more answer. Okay, one more answer will be, so 3 followed by 1 followed by 3 comma 2. This is one more answer. Like this, you do have many answers. You do have many answers, but people are expecting to have only one particular answer, something like this. You have to develop a state space tree like this, and they have to generate one particular answer, 1, 2, 1, 3. So it could be possible, but if you are interested, yes, you will go ahead and write many number of answers too. Okay, so this is the problem for graph coloring here. In this way, graph coloring gets operated here. There is a small algorithm which was given here to identify the colors here. So here, what exactly this particular thing is being gets identified? Let us have a look here. So this graph color will be taken, which is the next vertex which could be taken into consideration, will be identified by next value. So look at the next value kind of algorithm is this one. So if x of k equal to 0, then return x of k in the sense no graph is there. X of k will be equal to 0. What does it mean? No graph is there, then you can return here. If k equal to n in the sense you have traversed all vertices of that particular graph. That is the meaning of k equal to n here. K equal to n does means all vertices have been traversed. Based on that, you have written some x values. X values we have written just before 1, 2, 1, 3. So 1, 2, 1, 3 are the values here. 0 in the sense, no such graph. Otherwise, no such kind of color to be framed. So that is the meaning of 3 here. So x values must be always took place like this. Values of x will be 1 is less than or equal to, x is less than or equal to, whatever the number of colors you have given, m. Whatever the number of colors you have given. So these are the values of So let me say values of this particular decision making variable, that is x. Okay, if it is 0, no color has been given and no graph has been given, both are not given. Okay, then otherwise you can call the function graph color function, this particular function recursively with another vertex. So before going to take all these activities, let us identify which is the next so value of that particular graph color. So x of k equal to x of k plus 1 modulus of m plus 1. What does it mean? Let us consider m equal to 3 as far as the previous problem which we have given. X of k in the sense, so we have taken first value. Let me write the decision making variable here. 1, 2, 1 and 3. So here x of k in the sense k equal to 1. So that this value can be taken. 1 plus 1, that is 2. So 2 modulo division of m equal to, so that is 3 equal to 2 only. That is 2 equal to 2 only. 2 modulo division of, so 2 only. If you have x of k equal to 0, it must not become, the actual color will be equal to 0. So that is not supposed to be taken into consideration. So color value could be equal to 0. There is no color to be so painted out there. So that is the meaning of x of this particular thing. So x of k equal to 0 does means like that. So then if j equal to 1 and 1 to n, so n in the sense number of vertices, g in the sense graph of k comma j. So k in the sense second vertex comma j, so will not equal to 0, and x of k is equal to x of j. X of k in the sense whatever the value you have taken just before, that is 1, so which is equal to x of j equal to 1. Both are equal, so this condition is true. Okay, this condition is true. And k of g, graph of k comma j, k value is actually 1 comma j value is 1 here. So first vertex will be taken into consideration here. Then this condition will be, when this particular condition will be existed, then you have to break this particular loop and no value can be returned. Otherwise, so this value can be taken into j equal to n plus 1. So this value can be returned here. Okay, so k will be returned. In this way, k value can be identified. So in the second point, so k value equal to 2. 2 is going to be returned. And third point, so k value equal to 2. 2 plus 1, that is 3. 3 modulus of 3 will be equal to 0. So you could not do any kind of color over there. And that's a fourth time, so k will be equal to 3. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 modulo division of 3 equal to 1. So you can color something like this. In this way, this particular algorithm is going to be working. However, you are expected to try for if color will be starts with green, color will be starts with blue. So two more solutions could be identified, and write down all those different kinds of color combinations where exactly you have to color the graph, you have to identify, and you are also expected to write the same in the final examination so that you could get full marks. Okay, so this is the problem. This is the problem. In this way, you have to tell them. Okay. So don't go away. Let me take your attendance for a while. Don't go away. Yeah, taking up your attendances gets over. So we'll meet by tomorrow with another problem. The problem will be, where is your syllabus? Another problem will be this one. Hamiltonian cycle. So So graph coloring is just over today. Tomorrow we shall meet with Hamiltonian cycle, so that everything will be gets completed by tomorrow of unit number 5. Okay. Then we'll take some 1 or 2 classes will be take as break. Break in the sense you have a class. Make a class.